Traders, I'm going to finish my first day of the week down. As you can see, I'm down $15,000, a bit more. And several losers here. One, two, three losers, four. Four losers, one winner. Not a good balance. Definitely not a good balance. Well, tell you what, if I need to take a look at the trades I took today, that would be Boeing, where I shorted here. My target was here just under 166.50. And I did get to my target, but I was a bit greedy, so I did not take my partial, and the rest is like, you can see what happened here. So this could have been another winner, although I would still be in red, I guess, today. Kinda, yeah. And if you take a look at Beyond was clearly trending lower, shorted this one too. It's the time where the market was moving down close to the lows. At that time, Nasdaq was moving lower, therefore gave us a sign that maybe the S&P would move lower too, but Beyond refused to continue and moved higher, took me out. And a winner in GME, Huya, which I moved out. And if you take a look at ZM, that was a small size trade because it was the first few minutes. Stock started with a gap up, came down, this is bottoming tail here, moved over the highs, where was my long before that. And it just, I needed a bit more to take my quick partial with a smaller size in ZM. And again, smaller size because it's the first few minutes and you always risk a little bit less. Anyway, it's a big mover, therefore I've got a big loss in ZM over $3,000. So I'm going to finish my first day of the week down $15,000. And just last thing before, you remember we talked about the Monday morning reversal. The Monday morning reversal is extremely important. Look at the S&P at around the 30-minute mark. At around the 30-minute mark, it started moving higher. And I kind of hoped it's not going to be there today because it doesn't always work. But you know, on a Monday morning, we have a lot of open orders coming from the weekend. And therefore, all of this weekend, all of the open orders are getting executed during the first 30 minutes or so. Usually, it takes like 10 minutes to execute all open orders that are coming from one day to another. But since we just went through a weekend, it takes a little bit more. That's why after orders are being executed, the market could change direction, and it did change direction today. Therefore, on a Monday morning, you would expect a reversal. And I was hoping we're not going to get the low of the day at around here. However, once the market started moving higher, Boeing took me out, Beyond took me out, and that's it. So remember the Monday morning reversal. It is extremely important. And one more thing here. I mean, if I look back at last week and the way I started this week, I find it a bit hard to trade. I don't know how you guys are doing in the last week or so. But I finished last week a bit in red territory, just slightly, I think $2,000 or so in red. I had almost the same kind of up and down days, so just slightly in red territory. Well, that means, it doesn't matter. I mean, I was so just a little bit red, but the thing is, it was a hard week for me. And this week also starting hard. So maybe I should reduce my size, maybe not. See how the market is going to behave tomorrow. Always when the market starts with a big gap up like it is today, it's always a little bit more challenging to trade. You won't see the market starting with a gap up or down, up to 0.6%. When it's starting moving higher than that, it's becoming a little bit more challenging. S&P was up 0.8, Nasdaq was up 1.7 or so. Very challenging. Well, kind of tough week and a day. But I hope I'm going to do better the rest of the week. Anyway, have a great day today, traders. I hope you're going to do better than I did today. And I'll see you all tomorrow.